Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 5 in our series, statelesscode.com WordPress. So in this episode, I'm going to see about just getting basic styling, working, header footer sort of stuff. I'm going to play around with the Tailwind box model here. So the Sage uses Tailwind CSS as its primary styling framework, and so I'm gonna give that a shot. I don't have really any experience with Tailwind, but it's the kind of the big trend in front end dev, so I figured I'll kind of struggle through this and see what I can learn and do here. So we're gonna take a look at what we've got locally here. In the console, there is an error due to a 404. So I'm going to see if I can, what I can do about fixing that. There is a an issue on this about GitHub, on GitHub about this. There are a couple different options there. It seems like the simplest way to solve for it is just to create a vendor. An empty vendor.js file in public script. So I'm going to try that first. We'll see how that works here. So I'm also going to install a few extensions while I'm at it. So some PHP debugging stuff. See if there's anything related to Laravel blade. And then some stuff about Tailwind. IntelliSense working at least. And for now, we'll stop at that. So let me go in, see if my public scripts folder. We're just going to created an empty vendor.js there. Let's see if that gets rid of the red. And it does. So now let's start taking a look at the blade layouts and everything. So take a look at this app.blade.php. So one of the things that I noticed, and there are some good resources here, this in particular at, go back up, at Red Egg Marketing has a good example of Sage and Blade. I'll walk through there. But from looking at this as a Rails developer, this looks very similar to what I'd see in a an application.html.erb file. So we've got a main, we're yielding the content. We have a section for the sidebar if there is one, and then we're including the header partial, the footer partial. So that's what we've got here. So I should be able to, it looks like the it's using these Tailwind classes so that we can take a look at this. So let me just, for the sake of things, throw in a background color so that we can see what's going on here. We'll do this isn't going to be my color, but at least be able to see if we can find out what this box looks like for us. And that was not the right place to do that. All right, so I tried BG gray and see if that changes anything here. All right, that did. So we can see the whole item there. We go into our responsive mode. So that's kind of how large and wide we are there. So I think I want this to be wider on larger screens. And so that's the first thing I'm going to take a look at here. Right, so this is the max width documentation here. I'll just play around with this. Well, kick it up to 7 first and see what that does to us. So that made things much wider. Let me play around with this a little bit more. See what this does at various breakpoints. So we'll do that on a very large screen like what I've got on a 4K monitor here. You can see there's, when you do it that way, there's absolutely, and by default, kind of no padding or anything going on here. But that's fine, we can add that stuff in, but I think that's where I want to go with this overall, is to make it look big on a big screen, and then I'll just make sure that it stays responsive and gives us what we want there. So the next thing I'm going to do is can dial that back now that we don't need to highlight it. So, all right, so we can now take a look at the partials.header. And let's say that we wanted to make this gray 500. Not necessarily the way I want to go with it, but you get the idea. So that's our header for now. Obviously the contrast is lousy, but it looks okay there. Doesn't really break anything from a box model standpoint. So let me. So the other thing I want to do is All right. So yeah, I'm gonna wait on trying to customize colors and stuff like this. I'm just gonna use the Tailwind presets for now. What I do want to get into here is I'm going to copy the stateless code SVG into the public images folder here. I'll pause and do that. All right, so I've got the image there. Let me see if I can figure out how to try it, just see if that is part of a default require path or anything. Nope. Images. So I think I need to get the image into the resources. This is from an older version of to build it. see if there we go. All right. So need to fix my SVG so that it doesn't use fonts, but I'll make an episode on my enough Inkscape to be dangerous series to fix that, but that gets us closer. And I think so. Classes to this, I think. Oh, that makes it way too small. Tailwind images. All right, so there's that makes us too big, especially on a start with our try 12. Reasonable. I want to go maybe a little bit bigger than that. That might be too big. No, I like that. Okay, and then I do want this to be in line. Me, even though I know I'm in local dev, I'm going to change my go back to my dashboard here. My general settings. Make these match the actual site. There we go. Link starts on Sunday. Save changes. Let's go back to the site. All right, so I want this to display inline. it? It does not. Good hello world. Gallery. Okay, so let me check the Tailwind documentation for that. All right, so I'm going to try a float left on this image. Attribute. And we're starting to get long here, so we'll break that up. There we go. Although we need to clear it so that it doesn't bleed out of the header. Right, I'm going to try clear both. See if that gets me what I want. It does not. Nope. You can see my lack of sophisticated CSS skills here. I'm going to try throwing this in a div. Still going outside of that border. The other thing I'm going to try to do is do inline block here. Change. Throwing in some padding, see what that does. That almost gets us there. But gets us close. Let me see. It's a little bit. Chose a bogus class there, I think. Right, so what are my options here? I think it's near where I want. Let's see here. Doesn't look bad on mobile. And look at the other breakpoints here. Live with that for now. Let me get some padding to the left of this div. Bigger and larger sizes, I think. By default, we have small, medium, large, XL, and 2XL. Just to play with it. I'm not sure I'm gonna be quite so some space here. Skip every other one here. So that works. Get back to our larger works. Let's deal with the typography of this. Better, and I want this to be on a space. Transform it so that it's downcased. To have a centered. I want alignment. I want do that on the header. Might break everything I just did, but or it might do nothing. What did I just do? Okay. So really what I need here is margin top 6 gets us, too far. Doesn't look bad. On that. All right. So let's see what I can do in terms of color here. At the very least, I want to make this see what the gradient options are here. This, I'll throw that in there, and from maybe. I'll think about it. But that gets us a better header overall than we had before. It is not going to win any design awards, but it is not entirely generic, and I think we can at least deal with that for a first iteration. I'll stop here and we'll try to deal with some of the padding in the once you get outside of the header in the main content area in our next episode, and maybe even try to deal with the footer. So I almost forgot, let's commit this code and push it. So take a look at our status. Commit message. Look at my message. I'll sign it and commit it. And push to the remote.
Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.